Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to make a bar chart in Adobe Illustrator, and I'm also going to show you how to edit it and change colors without breaking the link between that and the data that it holds. We'll also add specific values to each bar in the chart. I'll show you how to do that. All right, let's get started. Okay, so I'm here in Adobe Illustrator. I'm just going to create a new document. So I'm going to choose print up here at the top, and then letter, and then create. Now I'm going to make my bar chart with this tool right down here, the column graph tool. But first I'm going to open up Google Sheets to grab some data, and Illustrator is going to use this to create the graph. I like to do all my editing in Google Sheets and then just paste into the little graph spreadsheet that we'll get in Illustrator, because it's just not very easy to edit information in Illustrator's version of a spreadsheet. So anyway, I'm going to select all of this and copy, and then we'll go back to Illustrator. I'm going to click on the graph tool and make sure column graph is selected. And then I'll just click and drag a graph. Then I'll hit paste and paste all this stuff in. And then I'll use the little check mark to apply my changes. And I'll move the information down here. Now, let me explain a little bit about what this data is. These are three stock sites, and this is the amount that I made on each stock site depending on the month. So Adobe stock, in January, I made $35, and actually these are not my actual sales. This is just an example. Some of the numbers are close for an entire month, which is sad. Okay, now the first thing I want to do is just hit S on my keyboard to get to my scale tool. I'm just going to bring it in a little bit like this. I'm going to change my font. I'll go ahead and make it avant-garde bold, and I'll change the size to 12. I'm going to go ahead and close my spreadsheet here, and then I'll zoom in. Now, it would be nice if I could put the 2022 automatically on the next line. So to do that, I can go back to my spreadsheet, and I'm just going to select all these. And the way to do this is, instead of a space, you want to put a little bar. And that's the one above the backslash key, which is kind of next to your bracket key on your keyboard. So I'm going to highlight these. I'll go to Edit, Find and Replace, and I'll make sure it says specific range here. I'll put a space here in Find, and I'm going to replace it with that bar. So we'll replace all. So you can see what we get here. And I'll say Done. Now I'm going to copy just that part, go back to my Illustrator file, and then I want to adjust the data. To do that, I'll go to Object, Graph, Data. Then I can just select my dates and then paste the new ones in, and we'll apply the changes. So what that bar does, it basically makes a line break. And this looks so much better already. Now I don't like how this part is kind of bleeding in here. So I'm going to use my A tool, which is my direct selection tool. I'll select just this first bar, and I'm going to hide it with Command 3 or Control 3. And then with my A tool still selected, I'm going to just draw a box around these things. I'll deselect that date. And then I'll hold Shift and just move these over a little bit. Then I'll go to Object, Show All. Using the Direct Selection tool is a good way to just move things around without breaking that link with the data. Now I want to add color to my graph, and there are a couple ways to do this. So I'll show you the simpler way first. Now I want to change this black to, let's say, green. So I'm going to get on my Group Selection tool, and I'll just click this once, and I'll click again. And then I'll click one more time, and this will select everything that's been grouped together. So now I can double click on my black and choose a different color. We'll change it to green. Now you'll notice that they didn't change to green, and that is because these are set to grayscale. So I'll want to open Window, Color, if it's not already open. Then I'll come up here to the flyout and choose RGB. Now these don't look as bright as they should because we're not actually in RGB color space right now. So I'm going to change that by going to File, Document Color Mode, and RGB Color. Then we can choose a brighter color and it'll look right. So that's one way to change the colors. I'm going to go ahead and undo all this, and I'll show you another way to do it later on. Even with moving these things around, changing the colors and all that, we're still tied to that spreadsheet, which is what we want. But if you ungroup the graph you'll lose the connection to that data, and then it'll be much harder to edit these bars later on. Okay, now one thing about Illustrator graphs that I've never really liked is that the numbers, like the amount I made with Adobe Stock in January, I have to guess whether it's between 30 or 40. But there is a way that you can get the numbers inside these little bars. And there's also a different way that you can get them outside the bars. And that is the more tricky of the two ways. So first I'll show you getting that number inside the bar. And I'll also show you another way to change the color. Now to put a number inside the bars, there are two parts you need, the bar and the text. You'll want to use one of the smaller bars to do this. So I'm going to click on this with my group selection tool, and I'm going to copy and paste it. I'll zoom in on this. I'm going to get on my type tool and just click one time and then type %00. It's really important that it exactly says that. And then I'll move it inside the bar. And I'm going to resize it to fit. So it's going to be pretty small. Now it should be centered, so I'm going to hit Shift Command C or Shift Control C on a PC. You can also open up your paragraph panel and center it right here. Then I'll select both and I'll just align those. I'm also going to change my color. I don't want an outline, so I'll get rid of that. And then I'll double click on my fill and choose the green color. I'll need to go ahead and set it to RGB in my color panel. And now we should be good to go. I'm going to make sure both pieces are selected, and I'll go to Object, Graph, Design, and then I'll choose New Design, and I'll say OK. Now I'm going to choose the color that I want to replace with this, and that was this darker gray. I'm going to get on my Group Selection tool, this one right here, and I'll click once, I'll click again, and I'll click one more time to select all of them. Next, we'll go to Object, Graph, Column, and I'll choose the new design, and then I'm going to choose sliding, this bottom one right here in the column type, and we'll say OK. Now you can see the number inside the bar on all of these. This one is a little low, so I'll use my direct selection and just move it up a little bit. And then you can repeat that for the rest of them. Okay, now if you want to add the actual numbers above the bar like this, there are four parts you'll need: the bar, the text, a guide, and a no-fill, no-stroke bar. And I learned how to do this from Monica Goss, or Gauss, I'm not sure how you say her last name, her YouTube channel. So if you want a more complete version of how it all works, you can head over there, and I'll link that video in my description below. Now, if you don't use all four pieces, it'll appear that it works, but the bars won't be as tall as they should be because it'll include that text as part of the height of the bar, which is not something we want. So here's how to do it. This time I'll copy this black bar and paste. And I want the bars on this one to have no stroke, and I want them to be orange this time. I'll change my color to RGB. I want this exact same piece of text, so I'm just going to copy that and I'll paste it. And I'm going to put it above the bar. Make sure that it's also centered above the bar and it's the font and size you want. Now I'm going to take the bar by itself and copy and then paste behind with Command B or Control B. You can also do Edit, Paste and Back right here. So now we have two copies, one on top of the other. The front copy I'm going to hide with Command 3 or Control 3. And I'll select the copy behind, and I'm going to make this no fill and no stroke by selecting none right down here. Then I'll unhide with Object, Show All. So now we have two copies, one has a fill and one doesn't. And then finally, we need to draw a line exactly across the halfway point of this bar. So I'll get my line tool, and I'll wait until my guide says it's intersecting halfway. I'll hold Shift and draw a line right here. So this is exactly the halfway point on this bar. Then I'll go to View, Guides, and Make Guides. Now this guide right now is locked. We need to make sure it's unlocked. On a Mac, that's Option, Command, and Semicolon. But you can also go to View, Guides, and Unlock Guides right here. Okay, so those are the four things we need. We have two bars, one colored, one not colored, text that says this, and the guide. So I'm going to select all four things. Then we can do the same process. Go to Object, Graph, Design, and New Design, and we'll call this one Above. and then we'll say okay. Now I'm going to use my group selection to select these black boxes. Then I'll go to Object, Graph, Column, and then I'll choose Above, and I'll choose Sliding right down here. And then I'll say okay. Now, unfortunately, when I did that, it undid my other color. So let me go ahead and see if I can redo that. Okay, I'm not sure why exactly that happened. Okay, and this is what we are looking for. And you can see that the bar goes exactly where it should go on this chart too. So right at 35 here and 55 here. So that's how to get the data of whatever this represents to be above the bar. So it's pretty tricky, and I'm not exactly sure why that works, but it does. So thank you, Monica. All right, if you like this video, please hit the subscribe button and the little bell next to it. You'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.